again. Oh. Hi.
You play baseball?
I love softball.
Hey, look at her fingers.
Oh, I think she's getting
everywhere.
Daddy? Daddy, there's your daddy.
Who's your
daddy?
I'm looking at beautiful.
Great.
Man, how'd you get so big so fast? She's like twice the size she was.
Almost.
Well, what are you doing here? What's going on? How did you get here? Why didn't you call?
Questions. What happened to welcome home? Come on, aren't you glad I'm back?
Here, hold your sister. Honey, glad. I'm more than glad. I'm ecstatic. But, God, honey, did you have to come back right now?
Every time I called, you told me that things were heating up another 10 degrees.
Right, and honey, as happy as I am to see your gorgeous face here where it belongs, you were supposed to stay put.
Until I was stronger, and I am.
Says who?
Who knows better than I do?
I do.
Says who?
Don't you just love it, little Lou? They're arguing. Mom's home.
You know, I ought to put the two of you in the back of the pink Cadillac and drive you back up to Beecher's Corners.
Well, you can't. Mr. and Mrs. Whitaker aren't even there this week.
Oh, right. Come on, honey. They're installed in that farmhouse like the plumbing.
No, they're not. Not this week. A couple of friends of theirs invited them to a 50th anniversary party in Chicago. And I could tell how badly they wanted to go. But you know something? They wouldn't dream of leaving me alone with the baby. So the only way that I could get them to make the trip was just to pack myself up, rent a car, and come home.
So it was an act of pure altruism. Are you getting this?
Well, I don't really care why they're here. I'm just glad they are.
Well, so am I. I'm glad you're here. But, sweetheart, the idea was to keep you and baby safe.
And don't you know that I never feel safer than when I'm here in this house with you? All of us. I miss my son. I miss my husband.
Whoa. Somebody who was married 50 years? How does that happen?
Well, first you have to be in love. You have to be like wild, crazy, nutsoid, fried in the grill in love in order to put up with the aggravation.
Not to mention the insults.
And then you have to stay healthy and out of danger.
No, Lucky. The real way that people stay together is by sharing everything. The good and the bad, the ups and the downs, and the danger.
You guys gonna make it that long?
I have every intention.
Well, me too, and I think we're off to a pretty good start, Lucky, because you know what? In a couple of days, your father and I celebrate 13 years of marriage.
13? No. Mm-hmm. It is?
Yeah.
13 years? And a son and a daughter, and I'm still nutsoid fried on the grill in love with this woman. Which is why you should get in the car.
No, the subject is closed. I'm here. I'm staying here.
What about the baby?
She's staying too?
Oh, yeah, she's fine. Look how strong she is.
I know she's strong. That's not the point. Of course she's strong. She's a Spencer.
Yeah? Well, I'm a Spencer, too, and I'm tired of having other people dictate the terms of my life. You don't know how badly I just wanted to come home.
Okay. You know what, son? This is another one of those times when marriage is like poker. You gotta know when to fold.
Well, I'm glad you did, and if you do it again, you'll have me to answer to.
All right. It's hairy as hell here, but we'll manage.
You bet we will. This is Leslie Lou.
Yes, sweetie.
Now, you be very, very good with this baby, because she's never seen anybody like you before. Right, honey? Okay. Maybe you need a nap.
Hey, Lulu, you'll get to know this old mutt, and you'll like him, like the rest of us. Of course, I wouldn't enter any drooling contest with him. He'll win.
Oh, well, we'll have to get him a drooly bib, won't we? A great big drooly bib.
Honey, how is it you managed to accumulate all this stuff, let alone load it in the car?
Catalog.
Did I have that much stuff when I was a kid?
No, not nearly this much, because with you, we had to travel light.
Travel light, you? You do remember the carpet bag.
Oh, who can forget the carpet bag?
You know, roughly a year ago when we bailed out of that airplane, your mother insisted on throwing the carpet bag out first. It killed a cow.
You're kidding!
Oh, yes, he is kidding.
In theory, but not in bovine.
No, he's kidding. Speaking of the bag, it's out in the car underneath everything else. Lucky, honey, would you do me a favor? Would you go outside and start unpacking the car for me, and Dad will be out and he'll help you carry the stuff in.
Yeah, don't try to lift that carpet bag on your own. You've probably got a carcass of that dead animal in there.
Stop it!
I love you.
Oh, do you have any idea how much I missed you?
Good. Same here. I guess it's safe to say the house missed you.
Yeah. I guess it is. Wow.
Oh, Luke, my plants. My gosh, they look pathetic. Didn't you water them?
I did, honey. I watered them. I watered and watered and watered this little sucker. I watered him twice, maybe three times a day. Till he started looking really sick, and then I stopped watering.
Yeah, well, that's because this is a violet, and it only gets watered once every 2 weeks. But what about the rest of them? Come on.
Well, they're all happy you're home.
And the laundry? You could have picked it up.
Oh, honey, the dryer blew up, and we were just sort of air-drying things. And then when I got the dryer fixed, by then, it was so comfortable, and it saved so much time to just come down the stairs in the morning and get our underwear off the railing, we just...
I see. And did it also save time to leave the dead flowers in the vase?
Those aren't dead flowers. Those are dried flowers. They're very in. I saw them in a magazine. People pay good money for this stuff. It's a look. Oh. It is. It's a look. Look
stop
how it,
it
looks
just
there.
Stop
it's
it.
A look.
Right.
I've missed that sound. I've missed that sound. Oh. I can't wait to hear more sounds out of the angel, too.
No, are you sure of that? I'll tell you, this little angel has quite a pair of lungs. Mm-hmm. In fact, let's not wake her.
Okay.
Luke, while Lucky's out of the house, please tell me, be straight with me, how serious is this situation, really?
It's bad. They damn near killed Justice. Which says to me that they're scared and they're desperate.
Oh, it just made me sick when you told me about the beating. How is Maymay feeling?
Oh, she's been a rock. An angry rock, but she's solid. And Justice is angry as hell, of course. He's out of the hospital now. Neither one of them are going back home.
So he's going to go ahead with his plan to campaign for Blake's seat on the city council?
Is he ever? Honey, she's so smart. She looked up at me and gave me this big grin, you know? And then she closed her eyes and started to snore.
Oh, well, good. Looks like you haven't lost your touch.
We make good kids, don't we?
Oh, the best. You know something? Leslie Lou isn't the only one who grew either. I think that Lucky looks like he shot up another couple of inches.
What'd I tell you? We owe it all to junk food. Hey, dog. I'm afraid the glory days of dissipation and eating on the floor, I'm afraid they're over. Nature Mother is home.
Hello, Foster. How is my boy? How is my best boy? I missed you. Oh, I missed you so much. Thank you for watching my other two best boys so well.
I think that's enough mush for the mutt, if you don't mind. Save a little of that sugar for me. Hey, Foster, let's go. Lucky's out here looking for you. Go find Lucky. Go on. Good boy. Good boy. I'm so glad you're home.
Are you really?
Am I? Really? You betcha. You betcha. Oh. Okay, Pumpkin. It seems like there's three ways we can play this. You're here, and I love it. I really love it, but it just might change some things.
How?
Well, honey, this, the fact that Justice is running for this council seat has heated up the incinerator issue into a full-tilt blaze. So I guess there's about three ways we can handle it. Number one, the Spencer contingent can quit and back off. Number two, we could work behind the scenes in a limited way, helping however we can, but not being fully involved. Or three, we can be totally involved and noisy about it. You know, that way maybe the incineration crowd might just not want to do any more dirt.
Yeah, know. Might. That's the catch.
Well, the problem is that this involves the kids. So I want you to make the call.
So scary.
I know. Being scared is appropriate. Depends on how scared are you.
I'm not scared enough to stay where I was. And ultimately, this whole thing, this whole incinerator thing, was about keeping our kids safe anyway, and not just our kids. We've never run from a battle. And I don't want to teach our children that. And there's Mary May. She's already lost a son to this kind of intimidation. Justice, our commitment to him. No. I don't see three choices. I see one. We stay. We stand up for what we believe in. You know, my mother always used to say, in for a penny, in for a pound.
How did I know you were going to say that?
It's too hard. About, happy anniversary.
That was close enough.
Man, this place looks amazing. Look what you've done.
Oh, you like it?
I do.
She just recited the whole Pledge of Allegiance with her little hand on her little heart.
Oh,
she did? With her little hand on her heart.
Presents, right? Time for presents?
Absolutely.
Oh, no, you didn't, did you?
Well, hey, listen, he can afford it, honey. He's raking it in with that worm farm business thing.
Really?
Raking it in.
Wow, Lucky.
Okay, Mom, Dad. Happy anniversary.
Oh, thank you, sweetie.
Son.
Oh, did you wrap this up yourself?
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's pretty rank, I know.
No, it's beautiful. It's really beautiful.
Whoa! A CD.
Yeah.
Motor City's greatest hits. Get out of here.
And Melissa cool. Manchester. Oh, that's great. I love her. This is so sweet.
You're too generous,
thank
son.
You. Thank you.
Especially
very
since
much.
There's like this one great. Fundamental problem.
What?
We don't have a CD player.
You take a hint, right?
Too subtle for me.
Next. Hello. Thank you for guarding it, Foster. Good boy.
Oh, I really wish you hadn't.
Oh, no, you don't. Open it up.
Oh, it's so pretty.
Woo! Dad!
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, well. My goodness. All just for a nursing mother.
For the sexiest woman in town.
Mom, you're blushing.
I know, yeah.
Are you still here?
Man,
no, this is what X-rays is like. I think I'm going to stick with PG.
It's your turn, Mom.
Oh. Oh, I wish the ground would open up and swallow me whole. Oh, no, Luke, with all of the rush to get here and the baby and the worry and everything, I didn't get you a present.
You didn't?
I didn't.
Look at him. Look at her. And look at the fact that you came here to be with me, despite the risk. I would give up all my possessions, past, present, and future, for the gift of this one moment in time.
My love, there's only you in my life, the only thing that's right.
My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make.
Resist your charm.